Now off you go then, boys, and happy hunting.
So, you have plans for your journey yet?
To Urinetown?
To Rio, of course.
Oh, yes, Rio. Well, I had to squeeze Cladwell a bit tighter for our monthly payoffs, extortion fees, and money bribes and stuff.
Caution, Officer Lockstock. It would appear we're no longer alone.
Well, I'll be.
If I'm not mistaken, that there's his daughter.
All grown up, too. Miss Cladwell, out a bit late, don't you think?
Hello, officers.
If I didn't know any better, I'd say you're on a late night behind the bushes to relieve yourself for free kind of walk.
Oh, no, officers. I'm just headed home from work. First day.
Long hours.
Just like us.
There's some kind of big vote down at the legislature tonight. Plenty of faxing to do.
And copying, I imagine.
Oh, yes, and copying.
I must say, Miss Cladwell, your father mentioned the size and purity of your heart, but he neglected, however, to mention the size and purity of your beauty.
Does beauty have a size, officer?
Some countries.
I take care walking out these streets late at night, Miss Cladwell. There's no telling what these people wouldn't do for a few coins.
Oh, no, officers. I'm not afraid of people.
Oh, no?
Not really. Everyone has a heart, you see. As long as you know that, you need never fear a soul.
Everyone?
Everyone.
Even criminals?
Even criminals.
Even policemen?
What?
Bobby's strong.
Out a bit late, don't you think?
Now, late taking care of another late night rush is all. There's talk of more fee hikes. People are getting edgy.
Are they? Well, I'm glad to see you're otherwise occupied. Wouldn't want to put you under suspicion for a late night behind the bushes.
Don't need to do that anymore, officers. Not while I work for Penny, I don't.
You still need to keep your head out of the cloud now, don't you?
What do you mean by that?
Well, all he's saying is, see that you don't end up like your father.
And how did my father end up?
Well, we're off. Our work's never done. Good night.
Good night, officers.
Good night, Bobby.
You were rather brave with them.
I don't usually care for policemen. Not those two, anyway.
Policemen protect the peace.
Do they?
Usually.
Didn't I see you down by the amenity this morning?
That was me. I was rushing off to work. First day.
Find your way all right?
To the gleaming tower on the hill? Couldn't miss it.
Beautiful.
It's rather shiny, that's true enough.
Did you mean what you said to those policemen? You know, about everyone having a heart.
Well, sure I did.
Because, well, because mine feels awful cold just now.
Cold?
Or empty. One of the two.
Not because of me, I hope.
Oh, no. Because of something I did.
Bobby. Bobby, reason with the woman. I'm a little short this morning.
No shorter than yesterday, unless I've grown.
Or rather, something I didn't do.
Well, if it feels cold, it must still be there, don't you think?
Unless there's a vacuum where it used to be.
A vacuum? In your chest? It sounds so implausible.
I did something wrong this morning is all I'm trying to say. I can't seem to get it out of my head.
The vacuum?
My action. I let someone down that I love dearly. I feel real bad about it.
Well, maybe that's nature's way of telling you that now's your time to lift someone up.
Really?
Well, sure. Do you think you'd be feeling as bad as you do if you didn't have a heart?
I don't know. I suppose not.
Well, of course you wouldn't. Because then you'd be dead. When darkness surrounds you and you lose your way, you have your own compass that turns night to day, and it's even with you before you depart. Be still, hear it beating, it's leading you, follow your heart.
Follow my heart? But to where?
To wherever your heart tells you to go.
Even there?
Even to the clouds, if that's what your heart commands. What's it saying now?
I don't know. I don't know how to listen to my heart.
You have to listen carefully. Here, let me try.
Do you?
Shh. Ah, there it is. It's saying, we all want a world filled with peace and with joy, with plenty of water for each girl and boy. That bright, shining world is just waiting to start. No meanness or sorrow, just cleanest tomorrow, if only you'd follow your heart. You see there? Even your heart knows you should follow your heart.
Peace and joy? Plenty of water? I guess I do want those things.
There was something else your heart was saying. Maybe something I shouldn't have heard.
There was?
I think so. It was barely audible, but I definitely heard something.
Well, what was it?
I don't know. Let me try again. Maybe I can make it out this time. There it is. So faint. It's saying, fall into the open air, far from the squalor and noise. Follow, someone is waiting there. Someone who shares all your hopes and your joys. Someone was waiting there. Why, my heart was telling me that exact thing just the other day.
It was?
Sure it was. Squalor and noise, hopes and joys. It was telling me about all those things.
I didn't know two hearts could speak as one.
I didn't either. Until now. Here, listen.
Someday I'll meet someone whose heart joins with mine. Aortas and arteries all intertwined. They'll beat so much stronger than they could apart. Eight chambers of muscle to hustle the love in our hearts. Love is kind and considerate. Love is peaceful and fair. Love can creep up so suddenly when you think of it, your love is there. We all want a world filled with peace and with joy, with plenty of justice for each girl and boy. That bright shining world is just waiting to start. No anger or badness, just laughter.
If only I'd follow your heart.
Well, good night.
Bobby Strong.
Good night, Bobby Strong.
And good night.
Hope.
Good night, Hope. I won't forget what you said about the clouds in my heart.
And I won't forget what you said about the laughter and the gladness. Wait a minute. When can I see you again?
Well, in this darkness, I'm afraid you can't see me at all. But a bright, shining world is waiting to start. I can feel it. Come to amenity number 9 tomorrow. I'll show it to you.
She loves him, doesn't she, Officer Lockstock?
She sure does. He's the hero of the show. She has to love him.
Yeah, everybody loves Bobby Strong. What's it like, Officer Lockstock?
What's what like, little Sally?
Urinetown.
Oh, I can't tell you that.
Why not?
Because it's a secret, that's why. Its power depends on mystery. I can't just blurt it out like, there is no Urinetown, we just kill people. Oh no, the information must be oozed out slowly in one mighty cathartic moment, somewhere in Act 2. With everyone singing, things like that.
Oh, I get it.
Well, I must be going, little Sally. It's time for the next scene.
The next morning at the amenity when the new fee hikes are announced?
That's the one. So long for now, and keep your head down.
And so, with this piece of paper, the UGC awards amenity number 9, the first of our new and entirely legal fee hikes, which we hope you will honor and enjoy. Of course, no one knows better than the good people at You're in Good Company how difficult times are, but research into finding the long-term solutions we need is expensive. So, for the time being, our decision is firm, and we look forward to going to Rio with our new profits. We look forward to finding lasting solutions and things like that. Good luck, Miss Pennywise, you and, well, you know where.
You can't do this to us, Miss Pennywise! It'll be off to Urinetown for a lot of us sooner or later if you do!
And it'll be off to Urinetown for me if I don't. Now form a line and have your money ready. The new beehive money, that is.
Miss Pennywise!
Bobby Strong, where the hell have you been?
I'm sorry I'm late, Miss Pennywise. I was up all night thinking, is all.
Up all night thinking, is it? You work here now, Bobby. You don't need to go in the bushes anymore.
I wasn't.
Like father, like son, that's what I say. Now let's get to work.
But it was about my father that I was thinking, Miss Pennywise. About what happened to him. About what's happening to all of us.
He broke the law yesterday, Bobby, and that's the end of it.
What if the law is wrong?
What did you say?
I said, what if the law is wrong, Miss Pennywise? What if all this is wrong?
Wrong? You got a sweet-looking head, Bobby. A sweet-looking head. But you keep it up there in the clouds, day after day after day, and it's gotta come down from there. You hear me? Get that head out of the clouds, Bobby Strong. You get it out of the clouds!
Off in the distance, there's a beautiful horizon.
All right, you know the drill.
Gleaming and radiant, it's what I'll keep my eyes on.
Same as it's always been.
As the world turns to face the sun and start another day, it suddenly occurs to me that maybe we can find another way. Look at the sky, full of hope and promise. It's a shining ideal, how I reel when I look at the sky.
Now who's first?
I am.
Ma!
Daily we make them pay their nickels, dimes, and quarters.
This is all I have, Miss Pennywise.
Daily we break them cause we have to follow orders.
Have you enough, Miss Strong?
And we keep filling money bags with broken lives and dreams. But what's it for? I can't ignore these black and moral profit-making schemes. Look at the sky, high above this madness. Here below, feel ashamed, it must stop in the name of the sky.
Here's all I have, Bobby. Is it enough?
You hold on to that money, Ma.
Really?
The fee is the law, Bobby Strong. She'll abide by it or she'll join her husband.
But what if there was a new law in town, Miss Pennywise? A new law that didn't come from any voting process or elected body or process of judicial review, but a brand new law that came from an organ. That's right. A muscular blood pumping organ, like this one, right here.
Muscular organ?
Can't you see it, Miss Pennywise? Well, if this one's too small for you, why not try this one on for size?
It's blinding me!
Look at the sky, there's a great big heart there. There's a heart in the sky, there just is, don't ask why, it's the sky! I don't think so. Come on, Ma, this one's on the house. For everyone, forever!
Hooray! Your heart knows all things great and true.
One thing your brains can never know.
Your heart points to the great big blue, where the people's allegiance must go.
Tell me where!
Look at the sky!
At the sky!
You'll be off to Rio then, I imagine.
I've already got my ticket.
Good work on the floor of the legislature, Fitz. It was touch and go there for a while, I understand.
Well, your Beaches of Rio slideshow changed their minds soon enough. same way it changed my mind those many years ago. God, I wish I'd never met you, Caldwell B. Cladwell.
Sorry to interrupt, Daddy. I just wanted to be sure you got your morning faxes.
Why, Hope, you're absolutely glowing.
It would seem that the office work agrees with her, what with the faxing and all.
And the copy.
Oh, yes, the copy. You're a good girl, Hope Cladwell. I used to be one before I met your father.
A good girl?
You heard me. $122, $123, just a few more.
Daddy, can I ask you a question?
Sure, Hogan, what is it?
Do you believe in love?
Love? Why do you ask?
I met this boy last night.
Sorry to interrupt, Mr. Cladwell. We've got a little problem.
Caldwell. Long time no see.
Yes. Anyways.
Anyway, it's about public amendment number 9, sir. The people have rioted.
Rioted?
They're peeing for free, Caldwell. I tried to stop them.
The assistant custodian is refusing to take people's money, sir. A young man by the name of Bobby Strong.
Bobby Strong?
They've rescinded the Public Health Act.
And the Water Preservation Act.
Can they do that?
Strictly symbolic, sir. The crowd gathered there is an unthinkably small percentage of the population as a whole.
What's happening, Daddy? I don't understand.
I wouldn't expect a good and pure heart like yours to understand.
Mr. Barrow and I are ready, sir. Just give the word.
What did I tell you, Cladwell? It's a powder keg out there, and I have a very, very important plane to catch. Excuse me.
But you're not going anywhere. Not until we nip this unpleasantness in the bud.
Nip? How so?
You're Cladwell, Hope. What would you do if the very foundation of your life's work were threatened by the rabble-rousing son of a convicted criminal?
Look deep into his heart and ask him what made it pound so angrily.
Angrily? No one gets angry at me, not without a beating.
Oh, Daddy, beating people is wrong.
Life is a beating. The sooner done that, the better.
Then life is wrong.
Embrace it. I have.
Life should be beautiful.
Life is many things, Hope, dear. Look closely. You'll see it. I do. I see it everywhere. A little bunny in a meadow. He's nibbling grass without a care. He's so delightful as he hops for you. You say, hi, bunny, and he stops for you. You pull your trigger, and he drops for you. Goodbye, bunny boo. Hello, rabbit stew. Get me, boys?
You tell him, boss.
Don't be the bunny. Don't be the stew. Don't be the dinner. You have better things to do. It ain't no joke. That's why it's funny. So take your cue. Don't be the bunny. Don't be the bunny.
But, Daddy, we're talking about people here, not animals.
People are animals, Hope, dear.
Animals with huge incisors and big floppy feet?
Look deeper. You'll see them. I do. I see them everywhere. A little bunny at a toll booth. He needs a measly 50 cents. Our little bunny didn't plan ahead. Poor bunny simply doesn't have the bread. He begs for mercy but gets jail instead. Hossing feathers in the air as the bunny gets the chair. See the moral, people.
Clear as day, boss.
Don't be the bunny. Don't be the dope. Don't be the loser. You're much better than that. You're born to power. You're in the money. Advice to you.
And read the bunny.
Don't be the bunny.
A little bunny at a toll booth.
You heard me.
But Daddy, bunnies don't drive cars.
Oh, don't they?
No, actually, I don't think that they do.
Live long enough, Hope dear. You'll see many things.
Even a daughter doubting her father?
A little bunny in a shoebox. He thinks he's found a brand new home. So snug and cozy on your closet floor. And then you open up your closet door. Now what's that bunny in my closet for? With a mallet and some clippers, you find out new bunny slippers! Grasp the message, Seth!
Right behind you, boss!
Don't be the bunny, don't be the shoe. You don't get stepped to oh, the one who steps is you. Stepping up to where it's sunny, step on the board. Don't be the bunny, don't be the bunny. Get yourselves together. It's time we bat ourselves a few rabbits. Let's go.
One at a time, one at a time, everyone will get a turn.
Calm down, let's go, one at a time.
Here's some cash, Bobby, just for you.
Keep your cash, friend, and relieve yourself in happiness.
A busy day so far. Busiest on the record if your books are right. How's the urinal holding out?
Oh, a little spillage, nothing to be concerned about. The people are happy, that's the main thing. Please, everyone, remain calm, remain calm!
It'll keep a lot of explaining to keep us calm, Bobby Strong.
We've taken control of this amenity, officers. The people here pee for free.
That's my amenity, officers. I want all these people taken away.
Officer Lockstock, what's happening?
Why, it's the Act 1 finale, little Sally. This is where Cladwell comes in and snuffs out the uprising. The bank's song and dance number involving the entire cast.
Snuff out the uprising? But what about Bobby's dreams?
Oh, little Sally, dreams only come true in happy musicals. And a few Hollywood movies, and this isn't either one of those. No, dreams are meant to be crushed. It's nature's way.
This may not be a happy musical, Officer Lockstock, but it's still a musical. And when a little girl has been given as many lines as I have, there's still hope for dreams.
Bobby?
Hope.
What are you doing, Bobby? I told you to follow your heart, not to seize an amenity.
I did follow my heart, Hope. Thanks to you.
The amenity won't take much more of this uprising, Caldwell. Bobby's a sweet boy, but not sweet enough to sweeten that spillage. Not by a long shot.
The amenity will take as much as it has to, Miss Pennywise. The days of deprivation are over for these people.
Yeah!
The days of deprivation have just begun if this madness continues a moment longer. Oh.
Sure, Mr. Cladwell. That's what you've been saying for 20 years. And for 20 years, we've waited for the long-term solutions that never came. Well, we're done waiting, you see. For a new day is dawn, a day of hope and happiness when the idea of human dignity is not a forgotten notion, but a living, breathing reality. A day, this day, where the people pee for free, because the people are free!
Yeah!
Free, people are free. How can it be? Enslave us, see how it can be free from the chains he gave us. We're suffering now, such lives of sorrow. Don't give us tomorrow, just give us today.
Free, people are free. How can it be? Enslave us, see how it can be free from the chains he gave us. We're suffering now, such lives of sorrow. Don't give us tomorrow, just give us today.
From every hill, every steeple, ring out the anthem of the people, making a new way, breaking the clouds of gray to sing.
Lisa will want to charge soon.
Your father?
Charge? Daddy, these people need understanding, not brutality.
On the contrary, Hope dear, a little brutality is exactly what these people need.
He only wants the people to be happy. Isn't that worth something?
Happy, you say? Happy? So you want happy Mr. Strong? Did you say happy Mr. Strong? If they pee today, I'm sure they'll be as happy as a pup. With no rules and no more fees to pay, things would be looking up. But too bad the water that we share could fit inside a cup. What if tomorrow, Mr. Strong?
But what if today?
But what of tomorrow, Mr. Strong. Think of tomorrow, Mr. Strong. Our resources are as fragile as a newborn baby's skull. With your rations, you would gut the child and leave a lifeless hole. Could it be you're so short-sighted, so insensitive, so dull? Think of tomorrow, Mr. Strong.
What about today?
You are wrong, Mr. Strong. You and your socialistic club.
If the people free, they'll push the system to the brink.
If it's you and me now, Mr. Strong, which one of us will win? I say it's you, Mr. Strong, for on the subject of tomorrow,
you are wrong!
Officer Lockstock, prepare your... man.
Everybody into the amenity. We'll be relatively safer in there.
Go, go.
Bobby, why didn't you tell me you were going to start a revolution?
Maybe for the same reason you didn't tell me you were a Cladwell.
I'm the same girl I was last night.
The girl from last night would have joined us by now, Hope.
I can't fight against my father, Bobby.
And I cannot fight against him. So you can join us or you can stand aside.
Stand aside?
You heard me.